Welcome back. Today we're going to be looking at the overclocks and hash rates of the NVIDIA CMP170HX. This is a 3000 series, essentially a NVIDIA GPU, but it uses HBM, so high bandwidth memory, which is the memory and the core on a single interposer die complex, which gives it an insanely wide memory bus. And because of that, it gives it some pretty lopsided performance, but I did want to take a look at the 170HX, which is right here. And honestly, this thing's got a couple of really crazy standouts. So not only is it like 4090 efficient, not 4090 hash rate, but 4090 efficient on Flux, 0.646, 0.5 or 0.55, in my opinion, is considered really quite good. Same thing with Nexa, we're seeing 0.688, really good efficiency. Again, about half the hash rate that you would see out of a 4090, but the efficiency is every bit as good. And these cards are quite a bit less expensive at this point. You can still pick these up if you know what you're doing for mid-400s US dollar, 600 if you really are just kind of throwing caution to the wind. Progpow, 0.262, again, quite good. Ironfish, I honestly don't even know if that result is accurate. It does seem like there were some errors in reporting. This is all software wattage. I was remote tuning this. Shout out to my man RONDY. This is his card. He put it on a rig late at night for me to test out one night, and I had some pretty good luck with it. Radiant, once again, really pretty good numbers. I'm not going to say that's standout. 10 or 11 I would consider to be pretty good. This is doing 14 hash per watt. Dynex, none of these numbers unfortunately are relevant, and I didn't test this on 1.0 miner. I really should have, but at the time 2.3.9 was yielding the best hash rates. Now of course we know that those hash rates were faked, so I have to wait for new miners to come out. I'd like more than just 1.0 miner to really give this another test. However, judging by what we saw there, the efficiency should be pretty good, even though the hash rate is roughly half of what you would get out of a Radeon 7. Makes sense. This is a 2048-bit bus. The Radeon 7's a 4096-bit bus. So, again, good, but we need to rerun all the Dynex results because we really can't trust these. I will say, I found the best result was using the intensity flag on SRB miner. So I don't know if that's going to be something that's going to be incorporated into all the other miners coming up here, but it might be worth looking at because stock, these cards are heavily power limited. Hi, buddy. And it's a little bit tough to know exactly what we're going to be dealing with. So anyway, I don't know why efficiency didn't populate. Looks like I didn't put in a wattage for Ergo, but they're extremely efficient at Ergo. Let's just put in 145. I don't even know. It had to have been more than that. Wow, okay. Sorry, I didn't get the... It was very late at night. But they're really, really good at memory hard algorithms. I think it was very near 2 mega hash per watt. 1 is considered extremely good. So the best Ergo card I've ever tested. Same thing with ETHhash. 0.817. So like a really healthy 30 series might get into the 0.6. But most cards you're going to be working with that we would consider good are like 0.5. So 0.817 is ridiculously good. The 170HX, again, I'd like to get one in hand to actually test with like the PMD to know if these software wattages reporting are correct. But either way, this kind of gives you a snapshot of what the card is like anyway with hash rates and telling you what it is and is not efficient with. So anyway, if you have one, great. I don't have one, but I was happy to test it. Thanks again to my man RONDY, and I will see you guys again very soon with some more hash rate testing. Hopefully we will have a new Dynex miner by then.